Hello students, today we are going to study about harmful organisms. You know students, diseases are of two types. One, communicable diseases, and another one is non-communicable diseases. Non-communicable diseases are those which cannot pass from one person to another person. While the communicable diseases we are going to study in the detail. What are communicable diseases? The diseases that can spread through a sick person to a healthy person. For example, you can see common cold. When a person is sneezing, the neighbor person or the friend's child that can also get infected. Now, what are pathogens? Because communicable diseases, we just have seen it is passing from one person to another person. And how they are passing? They are passing through the pathogens. Now the question arises, what are pathogens? So pathogens are those microorganisms which are responsible to carry the disease from a sick person to the healthy person. Now how the pathogens enter our body? This is a big question. They enter the body through the air we breathe, in the water we drink, or the food we eat, or the direct contact with an infected person, or it sometimes may be carried through some carrier. You know, carrier, it can be a mosquito, it can be a house fly. So these are the carriers of the diseases. So multiple examples are there for communicable diseases like chickenpox, whooping cough, measles, diphtheria, influenza, SARS, and in fact nowadays you are seeing and listening around corona. So COVID-19, this is also a communicable disease. That is why we all are shut in the houses with the lockdown. Here we are going to discuss some diseases found in human beings due to the pathogens. Now first we are going to study about the diseases due to the virus. So three diseases we are going to study in this. Three viral diseases in human beings. First is common cold, which is very commonly found. Influenza also we call it, common cold, sneezing, these all things come under. And you know the mode of transmission for this, this is air. That is why we always say if somebody has cold, then he should be away from the other healthy person. Another viral disease is polio. This is spreads through air and water both. And then we come to chicken pox. This is again a viral disease and it spreads through air and direct contact. So you can see all three viral diseases have air in common. Now see this. This is very interesting. This is very common also to see. When a female Anopheles mosquito, bites a person suffering from malaria, it sucks in the pathogens. Pathogens kaun se honge? Pathogens are the protozoans present over there, and the name of that protozoan is Plasmodium. So that pathogen along with the blood, when the same mosquito bites a healthy person, the pathogen or the protozoan or the Plasmodium may enter in the body of healthy person, and that healthy person may also get infected with malaria. So malaria ke liye we have another thing, we have a carrier as mosquito. So let's discuss protozoan, which is working as a pathogen for malaria, and this is transmitted through the bite of a female Anopheles mosquito. You must have heard about dengue fever, you must have heard about many other fevers or many other problems due to the mosquito bite. So malaria is out of them. Now next is cholera. Now we are going to study, as we have studied three diseases viral also, na? So we are going to study three bacterial diseases also today. Cholera is there. This is a bacterial disease and it spreads through contaminated water as well as contaminated food. Next is typhoid. This is again a bacterial disease and it spreads through contaminated food. Another one is TB or tuberculosis, we say. This is again a bacterial disease and it spreads through air. One more is there. Now we are going to talk about a fungal disease, which is also called ringworm. Ringworm, it's an allergic itching type of disease. It's fungal infection and it spreads very fast when we are in the direct contact of the diseased person. So we should be careful whenever a diseased person is around. We should keep ourselves we should stay from that diseased person. Now let's discuss about some animal diseases. You know, pathogens are not only responsible for the human diseases, they are responsible for animal diseases as well. So here we are going to study animal diseases caused by pathogens. Can you see this cow? It has some kind of spotty structures, swollen structures on the skin. This is called Rinderpest. This disease is called Rinderpest. And the affected animal is cattle. You are able to see cow here easily. And it spreads through direct contact, air and water. And this is a viral disease. Another viral disease found in cattle is foot and mouth disease. Can you see the sores on the mouth? Same kind of sores are present over there on the foot also in this disease. This is also affected animal is cattle. And mode of transmission is direct contact or air. Then we'll come to anthrax. Anthrax is a disease, it just means nasal passage. See, you can see the nasal passage, it's like bleeding. This is a bacterial disease and this is usually happening during the grazing. If the bacteria infects the mouth or area, then sometimes the cattle suffers anthrax also. Oh my God, you can see this fin. This is distorted kind of fin of a fish. This disease is called fin rot. In this case, sometimes it is bacterial, sometimes it is fungal, and sometimes it is injury also. Fishes are roaming here and there. Fishes are swimming here and there in the water, and sometimes they got affected by or they got collided by a rock. Koi stone hai wahan par, koi rock hai, usse takra jaate hain, to unke fins mein injury ho jaati hai. So at times injury, at times dirty water, so it can be bacterial, it can be fungal as well. And you know, it's not only animals or human beings. Plants are also being affected by pathogens. Can you see these spots on a citrus fruit? This disease is called citrus canker. The mode of transmission is air and the pathogen is a bacterium. Here you can see apple scab. These are the skin patches on the apple. And this is again transmitted by air and it is fungal disease in that. Another fungal disease we are going to study on the wheat leaf. Wheat leaf, but can you see these red rusty patches? This is called rust of wheat. And now here another fungal disease is loose smut. The spike of this wheat plant, it turns brown, it dries away and all the seeds are lost. Like we are not able to use these seeds. So this kind of diseases are also seen in the plants. So pathogens, you can see harmful organisms are really harmful for us. Though it's whether it's animals, human beings or plants, they all are getting affected by the diseases. Now here we are going to see how the food is getting spoiled. Microorganisms and the food spoilage. At times microorganisms are responsible for the food spoilage also. You already have studied fungus is always growing on dead or decaying plant matter or animal matter. So here it is the same process which happens. अभी dirty food, infected food, microorganism की वजह से spoiled food. इसके कुछ symptoms होते हैं. तो what are the symptoms? Food odor, they start smelling bad, slimy surface, discoloration. You can see the discolored tomatoes here in this picture. Sour taste and the gas formation. Can you see the fungal growth over here on this bread slice? This is again the same thing. This is the spoilage. And eating such kind of foodstuffs, that can cause the illness to our body and which is called food poisoning. So we should be very, very careful while selecting our food items. That's all for today, students. I hope you understood well the harmful organisms and the diseases. Next video will be on food preservation. Till then, stay tuned.